Most people panic when they're told they've got a vertebrae in their spine that slipped. I've treated hundreds of these cases, and what surprises nearly everyone is that a slipped vertebrae usually isn't a sudden injury at all. It's something that develops slowly, often from years of postural changes, small injuries, and repetitive stress. And I get it. The first thought most people have is, do I need surgery? But in reality, that's rarely the case. In this video, I'm going to explain exactly what's happening when a vertebrae slips, what anterolisthesis, retrolisthesis, and spondylolisthesis really mean, so you can finally understand what's going on inside your spine and what it does not mean about your future. We'll break down why this happens, how to know which type you have, and I'll introduce one of the most proven non-surgical corrective methods that actually targets and helps realign the spine in those conditions. Because once you understand what's really happening, you'll see that this isn't something you're stuck with. There are safe, evidence-based ways to help your spine heal and move better again. I'm Dr. Graham Jenkins, a corrective care chiropractor in Kelowna, British Columbia. For over 30 years, I've helped people restore their health, mobility, and confidence through advanced non-surgical spinal rehabilitation. I'm one of only a few doctors in the world who are advanced certified in chiropractic biophysics, and one of just three in the entire West Coast of Canada. My mission is simple: to help people live strong, active, and pain-free lives for as long as possible. I do that by focusing on real correction, not just pain relief, helping people fix the root cause of spinal problems that have held them back for years. On this channel, you'll find clear, evidence-based videos that explain how your spine and nervous system work, why posture matters, and what you can do to move and feel better naturally. If you're ready to take control of your health and start moving without fear again, subscribe to the channel. You'll discover practical, evidence-based ways to correct your posture, protect your spine, and keep your body strong for life. I upload a new video every week. When people hear that a vertebrae in their spines has slipped, it sounds alarming. It can seem like something suddenly moved out of place or broke. The medical term for that is spondylolisthesis, and depending on which way it moves, it's called anterolisthesis if it slips forward, or retrolisthesis if it shifts backwards. Now, that might sound complicated, but I want to make it simple. When I say a vertebrae has slipped, what we're really talking about is one of the bones in your spine shifting slightly out of its normal position. That small shift can cause irritation, pain, or even pressure on the nerves nearby. And that's often what creates the symptoms people feel, like back and leg pain. What most people don't realize is that this doesn't usually happen overnight. It's rarely caused by one big injury. Instead, it's a gradual process that builds up over time. Poor posture, repetitive movement for long hours of sitting, can strain the stabilizing muscles and the ligaments that hold your spine in alignment. Sometimes abnormal spinal curves, like an increased lumbar lordosis, can add extra pressure to certain joints. Over time, discs can thin, joints can lose stability, and ligaments can weaken. When that happens, one vertebrae may begin to slip slightly forward, known as an anterolisthesis, or backwards, called retrolisthesis. Even old injuries or falls can play a role by damaging the soft tissue that supports your spine. So if you've been told you have a slipped vertebrae, don't panic. It doesn't mean your spine is broken or that surgery is inevitable. It means there's been a gradual change that we can often measure and in many cases begin to correct. To really understand how this affects your body, let's look at what's actually happening inside the spine when one of these shifts occur. First, imagine your spine as a stack of blocks. When one block shifts, even a little, it changes how the blocks above and below interact. With spondylolisthesis, one vertebrae slides either forward, anterolisthesis, or backwards, retrolisthesis, relative to its neighbor. That shift alters the normal load paths. The discs between vertebrae become sheared and damaged. The facet joints, the joints at the back of the spine, take more stress. Then the ligaments that hold the bones in place start to stretch or weaken, Over time, the space around the nerve roots can narrow, causing irritation, tingling, numbness, or pain radiating into the legs. Also, when alignment is off, the body compensates. The muscles may tighten to stabilize the area, your posture changes, and your global spinal alignment may change depending on how the vertebrae slips. With these compensations, everyday movements like standing or walking become unexpectedly painful or difficult. It's important to understand that a slipped vertebrae doesn't mean your spine is collapsing. In many cases, these shifts are mild and stay relatively stable over time, even though they can still cause pain or stiffness. What really matters is how much that vertebrae has moved and whether that movement is putting pressure on nearby nerves. Next, we'll talk about how we actually diagnose and measure these kinds of shifts, why you may have been told you need surgery, and how to evaluate whether conservative care is a safe option. When it comes to diagnosing spondylolisthesis, imaging plays a huge role. MRI and CT scans can show a lot, including nerve pressure and disc damage. But there's one major limitation. Those images are often taken when you're lying down, not standing up. That means they don't show how gravity and body weight affect your spine. To really understand what's happening, we need to see your spine the way it functions in daily life. That's why a postural assessment and full spine weight-bearing x-rays are essential, which means the x-rays are done while you're standing. When you're standing, we can measure exactly how much one vertebrae has slipped forward or backward in relation to the one below it. If that movement is more than about 3.5 millimeters, it's considered unstable, meaning there's too much motion in that segment. These measurements also allow us to determine the grade of spondylolisthesis. There are 5 main grades of spondylolisthesis, based on how far one vertebra has slipped relative to the one below it. Grade 1 is a slip of up to 25%. Grade 2 is between 25 and 50%. Grade 3 ranges from 50 to 75%. Grade 4 is between 75 and 100%. Grade 5 is a rare condition where the vertebrae has completely slipped off the one below it. Now, grades 1 and 2 are considered mild to moderate. These are the cases that can usually be managed and corrected safely through conservative, non-surgical care. Grades 3 and 4 are more advanced and often do require a surgical consultation to prevent further instability or nerve damage. So now that you understand how we identify and grade these shifts, let's look at what can actually be done to correct the mild and moderate cases safely and effectively without surgery. What makes our approach unique is that it focuses on the cause, not just the symptoms. Instead of managing pain temporarily, we aim to restore the spine's natural alignment so the underlying instability can begin to resolve. This is done using an advanced, evidence-based corrective care technique called chiropractic biophysics, or CBP. CBP care starts with precise spinal and postural measurement. Once we know exactly where the misalignment is and how severe it is, we create a structural rehabilitation plan that uses specialized tools and corrective procedures to gently guide the spine back towards its ideal position. Now, in our office, we use a doctor-controlled traction system called RoboTrack. That's designed specifically for structural spinal correction within the chiropractic biophysics protocol. The system uses 5 electric actuators that control 10 different table movements, allowing the doctor to apply precise, safe, and targeted forces to specific areas of the spine. These controlled movements help realign vertebrae and relieve abnormal stress on discs, joints, and ligaments. Each setup is based on your individual weight-bearing x-rays and posture analysis. And because the doctor is in full control, every table position can be fine-tuned in real time for comfort and your safety. We are currently the only clinic in Western Canada with a RoboTrack system, giving our patients access to a level of corrective technology that is extremely rare and highly effective for complex spinal alignment issues. Be sure to subscribe to my channel, because in future videos, I'll be demonstrating exactly how the RoboTrack table works and showing you what makes it such an effective tool for spinal correction, especially for spondylolisthesis. What makes this especially useful for conditions like forward or backward vertebral slips is that we can target the shift in a very specific manner, rather than using generic traction that realigns the slip vertebrae. The RoboTrack gives us the capacity to deliver this level of specificity. We also use posture-based mirror image exercises that retrain the muscles and nervous system to hold better alignment, and specific spinal adjustments that complement these corrections. A 2024 case series by Curtis Fichorek demonstrated this exact corrective approach using chiropractic biophysics structural rehabilitation with the RoboTrack to align vertebrae in patients with lumbar anterolisthesis. Across three older adults, vertebral slippage improved from an average of 14.5 millimeters to 4.2 millimeters, with marked reductions in pain and urinary dysfunction and significant gains in quality of life. Follow-up exams more than a year later confirmed that these structural and functional improvements were fully maintained, providing strong evidence that targeted structural rehabilitation in combination with RoboTrack can produce stable, long-term spinal correction without surgery. What makes this process powerful is that it's measurable. Every step is tracked through reevaluations and follow-up imaging, so we can confirm that the spine is actually changing and healing the way we expect. As you can see, we can treat both anterolisthesis and retrolisthesis using proven non-surgical methods. And we're not just talking about reducing pain or managing symptoms. We're talking about making real, measurable corrections that can actually improve or reduce the amount of vertebral slippage. This kind of correction can help many people avoid surgery, restore proper spinal function, and make everyday movements like walking, bending, and standing comfortable again. It's about helping you get back to living a normal, active life without fear holding you back. If you found value in this video, make sure to like and share so more people can learn that there are real solutions for these spinal conditions. And if you have any questions about spondylolisthesis or the RoboTrack system, drop them in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you. I read every comment, and be sure to subscribe if you want to learn more about how your spine works and how to keep it healthy. You'll discover practical, evidence-based ways to correct your posture, protect your spine, and keep your body strong for life. The next video you should watch is this one, where I'll take you through four key exercises that I give my patients with spondylolisthesis. These movements can help you start building stability, improve mobility, and even reduce your pain safely and effectively. Go watch this video next.